I've been able to recreate this on VMIS. Okay, so whatever changes you're making on my Bible show here is also reflecting on the screen. You see, whatever Bible verse we're changing here is also reflecting here, and you can see how it's looking. The man of God on one screen, and also the scripture on one screen with other design as well. Yo, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So recently I was browsing through YouTube and I came across this. A subscriber also asked me how he can be able to recreate this using VMIS, and in this particular video I'm going to be walking you through that step-by-step guide on how you can be able to recreate this, or rather copied my template and recreate this using VMIS. Okay, so even if you have zero knowledge of graphics, or you don't know how to make use of Photoshop, you don't know how to make use of CorelDRAW, don't worry, you'll still be able to design something like this. So it doesn't necessarily mean you need to know how to use those softwares before you can be able to design something like this. Even with zero knowledge of graphics design, you still be able to do this. Okay, and believe me, it will come out great. Okay, so if you're just coming across this channel for the first time, or you haven't subscribed, hit that red subscribe button below to be part of our little family here on YouTube. Also turn on the notification bell when you subscribe, so you always be notified whenever I drop new videos here on this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you very much for all the support. Remember to give this video a thumbs up as usual, so the YouTube algorithm can also recommend it to other people on YouTube, so they can see the educative content we're sharing here on this channel. Okay, so without any further ado, let me take you through the step-by-step guide, or rather the walkthrough on how you can be able to recreate this on your VMIS software. Okay, so let's get started. The first thing you are going to do, let me just minimize this, go over and open your VMIS software. Okay, so I'm just going to do that. Open your VMIS software. I'm just going to wait for it to load, and our VMIS software is up already. Now after that, open your browser. Okay, so I'm just going to close this. Okay, open a new tab, open whichever browser you're making use of. Okay, and type in this website. You will also find it in the description below. It's called Post Out My Wall. I've also dropped the link in the description below, so go ahead in the description, click the link, and you will be on this site called Post Out My Wall. Now once you're on this site called Post Out My Wall, you can see the some of the design I've done. You see it here, so you see, so this one I did, see, this is it. And once you're on this site called Post Out My Wall, so go over and click on templates. Okay, so click on templates, and once you've done that, you see the church tab here. You can see this one right here that you're seeing, you see the church, so click on it, click on the church tab at the top, you see there, and scroll down. And we are going to be recreating this using what, which your design, let me just look for one. Okay, so we're going to be doing this using this design you are seeing right here on the screen. I've also dropped the link to this design in the description below. Okay, so you'll find it there as well. So go ahead and click it, and you'll be right on this page, and you can join me and do whatever thing I'm doing here. Okay, so I've also dropped the design that I've did. I've a couple of design, I've uploaded them on my Google Drive, so you can go ahead and download them if you don't want to design anything at all. If you just want to use the one I've designed, just go ahead and click at the Google Drive link in the description below, and you'll be able to download all the ones that I've designed. Okay, so let's go ahead and close this. So don't need them. Close this, and close all of this. Close all of this. So just follow through with what I'm doing. Just let's minimize this. Keep it here. Okay, let's keep it down below a little bit. And also this Facebook and YouTube, let's bring it down a little bit. Don't want it to cover the screen. Bring it down again. Push it to the left. Okay, let's see. So we are not creating anything from scratch. We're actually editing from the ones that have been created already. So which is why I said, even if you don't know how to use Photoshop, you still be able to do this. Okay, the Shine Ministry to the social media handle. Okay, so push it by the side here. I want the name to enter properly, and this is it. You see, this is the social media handle, and let's delete this one here. And this is the box we have. You see, this is the box we need. Expand this box. Expand it, expand the box. So I've done a couple of design as well, so you can also click on the description, download the Google Drive link, and you can make use of them. Okay, so if you want to create yours, you can also follow through and create them yourself. Okay, so I think we don't need this too, do we? Let's leave it. I think we might need it. Let's leave this one. I think we might need it also. Let's leave it. I'll drag it down. So you can show your weekly activities also as they're reading the scripture as well. Let's try and make it look fancy, you know. Okay, so Let's position this at the center. I want it to be at the center. Push it down. Push it down. I don't want it covering everywhere. I think it's okay here. Push it like this. And let's increase the thickness to 5. Or rather 7. I think I'm okay with 7. Okay, so increase the thickness to 7. I want to position it at the center. Okay. And that is it here. So now let's duplicate this. For you to duplicate it, you see the duplicate tab there. So duplicate it. And let's make this one smaller. Still going to push it down. Don't want it to be up there. So let's duplicate this. Push this one up a little bit. Push it by the side. And I think it's fine like this. Push it like this by the side again. And push this one also by the side. We don't want, okay, I can still reduce it, so we don't want it to overstretch on Vimix. This one, push it by the side here too. Okay, and you can see how everything is looking. Now, how do we bring in our own custom background? Let's bring in our logo too. Maybe your church logo or anything you want to make use of. So let's use this one, Hope TV. This is the logo. Okay. So you can also go through their design. They have lots of logo that you can make use of, that you can redesign for your church too. Okay, so you can even use it to design your flyer, whichever one you want to make use of. Okay, redesign this. And on Sunday, when is your service starting on Sunday? Type it there, 9:00 a.m. and I think 9:00 a.m. and also it's stopping at what time. You can type this one, put in Tuesday here too, depending on your church weekly activities. Okay, so your church weekly activities, you type in when it's starting, 9:00 a.m. as well, and you can push it by the side, expand it. Okay, push it down and push this one down as well, and you can see everything is fitting right fine. You can see we just designed our box and it's looking great. Now how do we change the background? Go over and click on it and click on the background. Okay so let's get rid of this first layer here. This is the first layer background. Let's get rid of it. Click on the background here and you can see background here. You can see background costume block here, and you can use color, whichever one you want to make use of color. See, so select whichever color you want to use. You see red, black, white, green, so whichever one you want to make use of. You cannot see this deep red, you see. So but if you want to use a custom background, go ahead and download it from Google and just type whichever color, blue background, blue color background, or whichever one you want to make use of. So just go ahead, type on it and go through the pictures, and you can select anyone you want to make use of. Okay, so whichever one you want to use, once you've downloaded it, okay, and you are on this side, go to photos here, go to photos here, and you see the add from my photos. Click on the add from my photos and upload photos. So upload photos and you'll be able to upload it from your PC. Okay, so and that will be fine, but I'm just going to select this one. And once you've selected your background, just use it and cover the whole scene. Okay, use it and cover everywhere. Use it and cover the whole screen, and that will be fine. Okay, stretch it to this side. You can see I've used it to cover the whole screen. Stretch it down, and I've used it to cover the whole screen. Now you see the backward there. This backward, not the forward, the backward. Push it backward. Still push it backward. Push it backward. Push it backward, and you see how it's looking. You see. See how great the whole thing is looking. Now once you're done with your design, go ahead and download it. Okay, so just let's also change this color to red. I don't want all the color to blend in together. I don't want some looking different. Okay, see, so once you're done, click on download, and you're not paying any money for downloading or for designing, so everything is 100% free. Okay, so go ahead and download, and okay, go ahead and download it. And once you finish downloading it, as you can see there, our design has finished downloading. Open your, you've already opened your Vimix software. Click on add input here, or you can just drag it and drop and select image. Okay, so select image, click on browse, go to download, and you see our design right here. So open, and okay, and this is it here showing on Vimeo. So you can see how it's looking. So you can see the design is looking elegant. So even if you don't know how to use Photoshop or CorelDRAW, like I said before, you still be able to do this, and it will come out great. Now let's bring in our video that I want to make use of. Okay, so I want to put in the smaller screen there. Okay, so let's bring in our video. Which video are we using? Thing comes, okay, End Time Church, important file, and let's use this one. Okay, so let's use this one. I think this one will be fine. Let's use this one. And once you bring in your video, or even if you want to make use of your live video feed, okay, so let it be a single shot. So it can't, the crowd shot can't go in the smaller part. It has to be a single shot, like of the man of God. Okay, so once you have your live video, maybe let's say for instance, this is my live video here. This is the man of God. Okay, so this is a single camera facing the man of God. Okay, as he's reading the scripture, as he's walking, the camera is also moving along with him, but the camera is not showing everything. It's only focusing on him. Okay, so giving him a tight shot. Okay, so giving him a tight shot, and this is it. Just double click on your picture, double click on it, and go over to layers and multi view. Okay, so once you click on layers or multi view, select this one, this number two here, select number two, and click on one. See this one here that is none here, click on it, and let's bring in the video.
God bless you, viewers watching me all over the world. This is
just one second, please.
The overseer of the entire Avestas.
So I've just tried to terminate the audio. I don't want to disturb what I'm doing. So now let's continue. You can see it here. Now click on this edit button here. Okay, in case you can't find this edit button, depending on the version of Vimeo you're using, and you can do this with any version of Vimeo. Okay, so go over to position here and click on main and select one, and this is it here. As you can see on the screen, you can just enlarge it. Let's enlarge this, let's reduce it. Okay, so and this is it. Now once you've done this, go ahead and crop, enable the cropping here, and let's crop it. Okay, let's crop this, and you can see it here. You can see how it's looking. Okay, so even if, or you can just copy this. Okay, so you can just copy this here, or this number here, and use it. Okay, so you can just copy all this number, and you can also make use of it as well. Okay, now how do we bring in our scripture on the big box? Now in order for us to bring in our picture on the big box, what you need to do is to go over and download Bible Show. Okay, so which is what you are going to be using to project our Bible. I've also dropped the link of the Bible Show software in the description below, so go ahead, click on it, and you download the Bible Show software. Okay, I'm just going to open the Bible Show software here on my PC. Just download it and install the Bible Show software, and once you've done, just open your Bible Show software. As you can see right there on the screen, it's currently loading the Bible. Okay, so the Bible Show software is up, as you can see. So this is how it looks like. Now once you've opened your Bible Show software, and click on this Bibles here down, you can see the option at the top, Bibles here. So click on it, and you can download any version of Bible you are making use of. Okay, so KJV, NIV, whichever one, GNT, so whichever one you're using. And you can also download it, Arabic, African, French, whichever one, just download it from here. Okay, and once you've done that, go over and click on configure here at the top. Click on the configure button. Now click on the NDI output and disable their display windows. Now by default, the display window will be on like this. Tick the NDI output, and you can be able to untick the display windows. Okay, so this is because we're using the Bible on the same PC. Okay, we can just minimize this. Go ahead and click on add input on Vimeo, and select the NDI and desktop capture. And once you've done it, you see the Bible Show NDI right there on the screen. So just click on OK, and this will bring in the Bible Show software. Now we've not selected any Bible. See, the screen is currently blank. Now let's go ahead and select any scripture we want. Okay, And also you can easily change your scriptures. You see the book, the chapters, the verses here. So just click on the verses out, whichever the man of God may be like, okay, I want to restart from verse. He started from verse 36 and he said, I want to start from verse 40. Just click on verse here, click on 40, and this is it. Okay, so this is how to change your Bible faster on this. Okay, so go over to themes. And you can see it here. So go over to themes and you'll be able to see your scripture on your monitor. You see the monitor here, and you can select whichever one you want to make use of. That's whichever theme that you want to make use of. And if you also want to download more themes on the Bible Show software, once you're on themes here, click on the download button right here on the screen, and you can select any collection of theme you want. Okay, so you can just select them, go through them, and if the theme you want to make use of is there, you can download it as well. Okay, so just like this one, want to use this one and I like it, go ahead and download, and that will download and install the theme for you. Okay, now let's continue what we are doing. Select our scripture here, Bible verse, and this, and play. And this is it, our scripture is showing on the screen. Now how do we bring it into VMIS? Still the same way. Okay, so you can see right here on the screen the scripture is showing now. So the same way, go click on add input, NDI and desktop capture, and you see the scripture displayed on the screen there. See the NDI show, NDI, Bible show NDI, select it and click on OK, and that will bring it in. Now once you've done all of this, go ahead and double click on your picture, okay, and click on layers and multi view, and the step number 2, click on it and select your Bible show NDI, okay, see right there on the screen. And once you've done this, you can either click on the edit button here as you're seeing, or you go over to position, click on the numbers and select 2. And once you've selected 2, let's minimize this. Okay, once you've selected 2, I'm just going to expand this so you can see it. Once you've selected 2, just you can just walk around the with it to just to the zoom Y, zoom X to make it fit in on the screen for you. Okay, see, and this is it right here on the screen. So you can also copy this, so this one you're not cropping. You can see I've been able to recreate this on VMIS. Okay, so whatever changes you're making on my Bible show here is also reflecting on the screen. You see whatever Bible verse we are changing here is also reflecting here, and you can see how it's looking, the man of God on one screen and also the scripture on one screen with other design as well. You can see how everything is looking. Whatever changes you're doing here is reflecting there. And the background is also changing the color on its own. You can see. So, and this is how you can be able to recreate this on VMIS. Okay, in case you love this video, remember subscribe to this YouTube channel and also turn on the notification bell so you always be notified whenever I drop new videos here on my channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, share this video so that everyone on YouTube or outside the YouTube can also be part of our little family here on the YouTube. Okay, so see you in our next updates.